thanks. We give you praise. As we gather as school parents, teachers, with our students, our children of this school, as they prepare to take that next step, as they take the next step from this school and begin the process to journeying to the secondary schools after all that they have done in preparation for this. And so, Lord, we thank you and we praise you for this graduation ceremony that we are undertaking this morning. We thank you, Lord, for each child, each gift. We thank you, Lord, for the teachers who helped to prepare them, who brought them to this point. We thank you, Lord, for their parents and their loved ones gathered here this morning. We pray, Lord, that as we enter into this celebration, as we give you thanks, as we give you praise, as we bless each child for their performance, for their hard work, for their energy, for all that they have done in these past years in this school, as we pray for them as they move on now to secondary school, that, Lord, we will truly come to know that you are here in our midst, present to us and present to each child. Bless this ceremony, bless us. Bless those who will speak to the children. Bless all that they will receive today. And Lord, we pray that as they leave this school, as they move on to secondary schools, that they will take all that they have learned, enabling them to continue to pursue higher knowledge, higher understanding, and in that way, Lord, be guided by your divine hand. Bless all that we do today. Hear our prayer. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you very much, Father Ronald, for leading us in prayer this morning. We kindly ask you to remain standing for the national anthem, to be led by our beautiful and talented Jade Alexander.
Mrs. Emily Pear, parliamentary representative elect. Father Ronald Holder, representing the parish priest. Mrs. Ann David Antwine, former Minister of Health. Mr. Peter Ridges, district education officer, District 3. Ms. Christine Smith, school attendance officer. Ms. Maria Viveg, Executive Secretary, of the Catholic Education Board of Management, Ms. Rhonda Joseph, the school's counselor, Mr. Ernest Richardson, and Mr. Roland Hood, school attendance officers, Ms. Rolanda McQueen, former senator, Mr. Samuel Alexander, our guest speaker, Ms. Rikisha St. Louis, president of the school's PTA, our retired and past teachers, our special invited guest, principals, teachers, parents, well-wishers, graduates, welcome.
It is with great pleasure we stand before you all this morning and welcome families, friends, members of staff. Graduation Day 2022 at St. Martin the Porres RC School under the theme Aspiring for Excellence Through Hard Work, Discipline, and Faith in God. We thank you for collaborating with us on such a blissful event. To all graduates sitting anxiously in our midst, it's your big day. I would like to congratulate you on your great academic achievement. This achievement of yours, challenging of times as the country was under the threat of COVID-19. However, you stood the test of times as the motivational speaker Les Brown said, if you do what is easy, your life will become hard. But if you do what is hard, your life will become easy. End of quote. It's because of your hard work and dedication and faith in God, you sit among your peers on such a joyous occasion. We are only here today to celebrate with you, applaud you, and encourage you to shoot for the moon. When you leave here today, you're not only going to be graduates, but you're also going to be ambassadors for this noble institution. Always keep in mind that this school expects you to remember that at all times and in all places, you are its representative. Graduates of 2022, I encourage you to aim for the moon. So if by chance you miss, you will land among the stars. Once again, I welcome you all.
And do not be afraid to clap this morning. Amen? Yes, don't be afraid to clap. We will now listen to the scripture reading by J. Donna Alexander, after which Father Ronald will briefly reflect on it, the reading.
Reading from Romans chapter 12, verse 9 to 16. Let love be sincere. Hate what is evil and hold to whatever is good. Love one another and be considerate. Outdo one another in mutual respect. Be zealous in fulfilling your duties. Be fervent in the spirit and serve God. Have hope, be cheerful. Be patient in trials and pray constantly. Share with other Christians in need with those passing by. Be ready to receive them. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not wish evil on anyone. Rejoice with those who are joyful and weep with those who weep. Live in peace with one another. Do not dream of extraordinary things. Be humble and do not hold yourself as wise. The word of the Lord.
And in addition to that reading, I want to read to you from the reading for today. The gospel for today comes from Matthew 8, 23 to 27. Jesus got into the boat followed by his disciples. Without warning, a storm broke over the lake. So violent that the waves were breaking right over the boat. But he was asleep. So they went to him and woke him, saying, "Save us, Lord, we are going down." And he said to them, "Why are you so frightened, you men of little faith?" And with that he stood up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and all was calm again. The men were astounded and said, "Whatever kind of man is this? Even the winds and the sea obey him." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So, young people, Watch me. I'm here. Focus. Are you ready? Ready for what? The graduation? Or ready for secondary school? You sure you're ready? Why you think you're ready? Why you think you're ready? Because what? Can I hear you? Because what? Okay. As you take this step, as you move from this school to the next, you're continuing your journey. What are you continuing? Life is a journey. What is life? And on this journey of life, you're going to face many storms. Are you hearing me? What are you going to face? You're going to face many storms. Yes, we are in a moment sort of hoping, praying that this coming storm that's heading towards us, that's supposed to arrive sometime this afternoon or this evening or tomorrow, whenever it gets here, that it won't create any damage. So we're praying for that, right? Right? Wonderful. But in addition to that, we're praying that all the storms you will face in life, and they're going to be many, one after the other, that you're going to ask God to help you to know that you should not be afraid. You're going to ask God for the grace not to be afraid. What are you going to ask him? Not to be afraid, because at the heart of our storm is fear. Are you listening to me? At the start of the storm is fear. And therefore, you need to pray for the grace not to be afraid. Why? Because God is in the storm with you. Who is in the storm? Who is in the storm? God is in the storm. And as much as he may appear to be asleep, as much as he may appear to be asleep, that's what the gospel said. He was asleep. Jesus was asleep in the boat. And so they had to go and wake him. So as much as it may come across that our God might be asleep, he's not asleep. In fact, they woke him and he said, "Why are you so frightened, O you of little faith?" And therefore, we need to pray for faith. What do we need to pray for? What do we need to pray for? Faith. That as we face our storms, as we face the many storms, it could be the storm of bullying, because when you get into the secondary school, you're going to face others who will bully you, right? We're going to fight that. We're going to overcome that. It could be the storm of maybe the schoolwork, the work you're doing, the subjects you're doing might become harder and more difficult. You're going to face that storm. It might be the storm whereby you may not be understanding the teacher or teachers as they seek to pass on this knowledge to you. You're going to face that storm. It could be the storm of things just becoming harder and harder. You're going to face that storm. Whatever your storm, I want you to be assured that God is with you. Who is with you? Who is with you? And therefore, as God is with you, trust him. Get to know him, because I know you may be at the stage of your life where you really don't know him as well as you ought to. Get to know him. Allow him to be the center of your life. Allow him to be first in your life. There'll be many distractions. I assure you, there are going to be many distractions. But don't let those distractions take you away from your goal. God has a plan for you. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? God has a what? What does God have? God has a plan for you. And therefore, I pray that you will be open to God's plan for your life. That you'll be open to what God, to where God will bring you. And in that way, as you keep fighting your storms, as you keep struggling and meeting your storms, may the Lord give you the grace to overcome each storm until you get to heaven. May the Lord be present to you. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord guide you. May you come to know the love of the Lord and be open to his love in your life. And to the parents, to the loved ones gathered here to celebrate the gift of your children, to celebrate the gift of each child, I pray that the Lord will bless you. I pray that the Lord will strengthen you. But I plead with you, parents, I'm pleading with you. Please affirm these children. Don't just see this as every exercise or graduation, but encourage them. Make time to pray with them. Make time to be present to them. Hug them. Tell them you love them. And as you accompany them on this journey, may they come to experience this love of yours. Make time for church. Wherever church you're going to, make time for church. Put God first. A lot of our families today are in crisis. We need to get back to that point of putting God first. And in that way, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless them. And may the Lord truly help us as a people, as a nation, as we walk on this onward journey, that he may bless us and guide us and direct our paths. Amen.
Thank you very much, Father, for your words of inspiration. I now invite Anila Isaac to lead us in the graduation prayer. And I also want to request that we all stand while she leads us in prayer.
gracious God, we release before you the graduating class of 2022. As this chapter of our lives closes and we begin a new journey, we ask that you fill our minds with your thoughts, fill our bodies with your strength, and fill our hearts with your dreams. We ask for your wisdom and clear direction over our lives so that we may be successful in our secondary schools. May you surround us with friends and leaders who will challenge us to use our energies positively and to press closer to you. May we be strengthened and instilled with hope for the new road you have in store for us. We thank you for our time spent at this institution and for all the times of great discovering and learning. As we begin this new journey, continue to empower us so that we may aspire for excellence through hard work, discipline, and faith in God. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Anila, for praying on behalf of your fellow graduates. You may have your seat. Alfred North Whitehead said, and I quote, "No one who achieves success does so without acknowledging the help of others. The wise and confident acknowledge this help with gratitude. Therefore, it will be remiss of us if we do not acknowledge at this point the hard work, sacrifice, and the commitment of both teachers Yvette and Siobhan, and not forgetting the assistants, teachers Nikeshi and Sheena, in preparing the students to reach this point. We know it was not an easy task, but we applaud you. We applaud your efforts and dedication through it all. These 46 students have received a well-rounded education from our institution, and they are charged to go forth, to aspire to be all that they can be, to dream big and aim for excellence, always, not sometimes, but always, while building your faith in God. At this time, we will invite teachers Donna and Aloydris to present to you a slideshow of the graduating class of 2022. Let's put our hands together this morning.
Good morning to everyone. Striving for excellence through hard work, discipline, and faith in God, these successful candidates had done just that. And because of their discipline in attending school regularly and on time, and also by putting their trust in God, we are all here to celebrate their success. Happy are we to present to you this year's graduating class. Birona Dairona Mack, Naomi Maureen, Diamond Charles, Katie Williams, Ariana Lousy.
Angel Jafal, Amila
Tiana James, Jelisa Sparks, Tiona Jackson, Nivea Sentile, Kenaya Raymond.
Kimia Mitchell, Joriel Felix, Jade Alexander, Jordan Mitchell, Mazel Alexis.
Jadonna Alexander, Haley Felix, Ruth Macmillan,
thank you, graduates. You can now have your seats. All right, so thank you to Teacher Donna and Teacher Lloydris for the presentation. And we now invite the graduates to present us with a poem.
Thank you.
Thank you, graduates. You may have your seat. For many years, this gentle yet has been giving managerial service to our noble institution. He has helped his students and staff through one of the toughest times for leadership and is still serving with fervor and distinction. Let us welcome to the microphone Mr. Kester Lyons, our dear principal, to share about the academic year 2021 to 2022.
Mrs. Emmeline Peer, Parliamentary Representative Elect. Mrs. Anne David Antwine, former Minister for Education, former student, and former teacher of St. Martin de Porres Catholic School. Father Ronald Holder, representing the parish priest. Mr. Peter Ridges, District Education Officer. Other officials on the Ministry of Education, Mrs. Rhonda Joseph, Schools Counselor, Ms. Rolanda McQueen, former Senator, Mr. Samuel Alexander, guest speaker, Ms. Rikisha St. Louis, President of the Schools PTA, retired teachers, specially invited guests, and let me recognize Mr. Kitaka Mautu, one of our specially invited guests, teachers, parents, well-wishers, class of 2022, good morning. Today, I stand proudly representing staff, students, and parents to present the school's report for the academic year, September 2021 to July 2022. Before I venture any further, please permit me to offer hearty congratulations to you, the graduating class of 2022. You have done well, and you have made us proud. You have worked hard, and now you are reaping your reward. This year, a total of 53 students were registered to write the exams. Of that number, 46 students were successful and awarded places in the various secondary schools. Six students, namely Latasha Kadu, Dairona Mack, Anilia Isaac, Jadonna Alexander, Dante Jones, and Jediah Lessey were top performers on the first 200 in the island. Latasha Kadu was our top performer with a total of 456 marks in the exam. Again, hearty congratulations. We continue to recommit ourselves to the students who are not awarded a place in this year's exam. To you, our dear boys and girls, do not be discouraged. Let us work together to help you cross the line. What is needed is just a little more effort and perseverance to reach that goal. I say, never give up. The year began in the face of uncertainty and adversity for yet another year. We were able to welcome all our students back to school to face-to-face learning in September. We understood the level of frustration that came with these challenges, especially for you parents who had to go to work and in many cases had to make alternative arrangements for your children. However, we were in a better place, as we had in most cases government-issued tablets and laptops to facilitate online learning. Despite our best efforts, when we finally returned to school for face-to-face learning, many teachers and students were infected with the virus, creating further disruption to the teaching and learning process. It must be said, it was indeed a challenging year. Despite the challenges, however, we persevered. We had to scale back on Child Month and independence activities due to the school being on rotation at the time. Unfortunately, we were unable to host our annual athletic sports, for which we truly regret and deeply apologize. We understand how stakeholders look forward to this activity, but there is light at the end of the tunnel. And from where we sit, we believe that 2023 will see the biggest sports meet once we are not hindered by the pandemic again. In February of this year, we received a donation of 17 desktop computers, 3 laptops, a printer, and a projector from a non-profit organization, GrenVet. Immediately, through partnership with our then parliamentary representative, Honorable Emlyn Pear, we were assisted with an IT teacher and began offering IT classes to our grade 4, grade 5, and grade 6 students. These classes, ladies and gentlemen, will continue in September and will extend to the lower classes of the school. At last year's graduation, I gave you our commitment to create a scholarship in the name of our former principal, Mrs. Catherine Simeon. This scholarship will seek to provide financial support to 2 students each year for the duration of their secondary school. I'm happy to announce that Dante Jones and Naomi Maureen are the recipients of this year's award. This will be done in a short ceremony in the weeks to come. We wish them well. I wish to thank the Noel family for their donation for the beginning of this fund and ask you, our parents, and other well-wishers to play your part so we can keep that fund functioning. I must pause to express thanks to several persons who continue to support our school each year, to our education officer and to other officers on the Ministry of Education. We thank you for your support and guidance. To Parliamentary Representative-elect Honorable Emlyn Pear, we thank you for always looking out for us and assisting us. We have been able to partner with some of our past students for our awards and trophies this year. We thank you for your support. I wish to also mention former Minister for Health, former student and former teacher, Mrs. Anne David Antwine, who is always sending a little something for the school. Thank you very much, Mrs. Antwine. Teacher V and Teacher Cinti, words cannot express how grateful we are for your donations to our school. We love you and we appreciate you. To you, past student, Mr. Solomon Braffitt, we thank you. You found it in your heart to make a donation of fruit to every student of the school so that they can have a healthy break sometimes. We thank you very much. Mrs. Rolanda McQueen, you are always there supporting our needy students. We thank you. The business community, parents, The PTA executive, thank you for your support. And this year, for yet another year, the PTA executive took it upon themselves to ensure that every student writing the CPA had a package with the necessary tools. Thank you very much for that initiative. Parents, you have done well. Continue to support your students. Continue to mold and nurture them, and do not be afraid to show them your love. To the staff of this noble institution, I am proud of your efforts. Thank you for your continued support. Let us continue to do our best as we strive for success. Let us remember that we will not settle for second place. We must do our best to be our best. Let us improve on our shortcomings so that our school will be even better. To the graduation committee and all the subcommittees, job well done. Thank you. To you, my dear boys and girls, I wish you well. Every year I get to this point, I always ask myself, I wonder which class is the best class. All right, don't be quarreling now. And I always have a hard task in answering this question. But this is a very unique class, and I'll tell you why. Because you see, this class had cranberry, it had pumpkin, it had chunkulungs, it had Michael Jackson, it had Jewel of the Sea, it had Diamond of the Sky. So this class was a very unique class because I found a pet name for almost everyone in the class. And they found some pet names for me too, which I would not share this morning. But one of the things that they did on a very regular basis was to come and rub my head, and also my tummy. And some would ask, sir, when are you having the baby? And I would always say to them, I am going to make all of them godparents. So to this special class of students who are leaving us, I want to wish you well. Many persons would encourage you to go out there and to be stars. I am challenging you to be superstars. Let this success serve as a catalyst for you to continue to work hard so that you will reap greater success in the future. We will surely miss you. I encourage you to conduct yourselves well. Stand tall. Dress properly. Speak properly. What you say is a reflection of you. Be obedient to your parents and teachers. We will miss you, and we will always love you. But do not forget, very soon you'll be past students of the best primary school in Grenada, Carriacou, and Piti Mati. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, class of 2022. My name is Liselle, and I was sitting exactly where you are sitting right now, 26 years ago, in 1996. Congratulations on a job well done. You did well. Your family is proud, your parents are proud, teachers, friends, I am proud of you. But I want you to be open and have an open mind and accept these new challenges that come forth. I mean, you accepted this one and look where you are right now, right? So accept this new challenge, enjoy this moment right here. You did amazing. Enjoy this moment, enjoy big wins, enjoy small wins. And I wish you all the best with everything you have to do in the future. Good luck, all the best, and congrats.
We are delighted to have our parliamentary representative elect, Mrs. Emlyn Pear, sharing this memorable moment with us. We would like to congratulate you on your success in the recently held general elections. Let us welcome Ms. Spear as she gives some brief remarks as well.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Let me say a very warm good morning, of course, Father Holder. I want to especially, in the interest of time, recognize the principal, officials from the Ministry of Education, of course, all very distinguished guests on the invitation of the school, parents, students all, good morning. It is indeed an honor for me to share this occasion with you, and I find myself in exactly the same trap that I ended in last year, having two graduations starting at the same time with my name appearing on both programs. Last year I asked, Principal, are you sure you're going to start on time? I'm going to come by you first, spend 1 hour, and rush off. I got the same answer this year. We're going to start on time. Of course, I recognize you were ready, but you had technical difficulties. So I know I would not be forgotten or forgiven, because I was told in a WhatsApp, the guest speaker was speaking about 15 minutes ago. Will I catch them? I'll try. So this morning, I want to share very, very quickly, and want to first of all recognize that this school has been growing and growing and growing, and I believe that this school, it's well on its way to achieving its fullest potential as an institution. And I want to recognize that. I also want to recognize the principal, the staff, and all the supporters of this school. And I believe the strength of this school rests really heavily on the level of partnership and support from its stakeholders. And so this morning, I really want to recognize all of those who have contributed in one way or the other to the success and the development of this institution. Continue to shine, continue to grow, continue to go. You are going extremely well. And note, you have my continued support. I looked at the program this morning, and the first thing that popped out to me, I don't know if it popped out to you, was the list of boys. I want to ask all the boys to stand this morning. I don't know if you looked at the program, and if you compared the girls' list and the boys' list and how short the boys' list was. And so this morning, I want to say, first of all, to you, the boys who are moving on, you are special. You know that? Very special, too. There's a book that I came across very recently that said, men are at risk. Men are at risk. And very often in the Caribbean, when you speak about student performance, of course, the males are always a concern. And so that is why I want to challenge you this morning that you are going to do well. As males, you are going to succeed, you are going to complete your 5 years at secondary school, and you are going to be so proud of yourselves. Your family would be so proud of you. Do not allow anyone to make you believe that you are so different that you cannot perform well. Do I have a commitment from you that you are going to shine and you are going to do very well and you're going to make your parents proud? Very good. Thank you. I want to encourage you because you can say thank you. I want to encourage you because there is a perception about our male students. There is a perception. But I believe it is only a perception. So some research would tell you that boys do not do as well as girls in certain areas. But we've seen boys who did just as well and even better. And so my fundamental view, both boys and girls can match each other in terms of their performance, in terms of excellence. And that is my challenge to the boys behind. Do not listen to the other voices. This morning, I want to challenge you students as you leave this institution. And in doing so, I want to commend your principal and all your teachers for all that they have done to help to prepare you for this next leg of the journey. So this is a very important milestone that you've arrived at. You are now starting a new journey in September that I'm sure you would be just as successful, even more successful. And so I want to challenge and encourage you this morning to continue to strive for excellence. Continue to strive for excellence. I know that you have the support of your parents. I know you have the support of your teachers and all of those who are close around you. Continue to strive for excellence. But in saying this, there are two words that I want to leave with you this morning. Faith, belief. What are they? Faith, belief. Actually, those two words define a word that I'm sure you are all familiar with. That word this morning produces those two words that I want to just quickly mention to you how important they are as you go forward. And I'll start with faith. When Father Ronald shared briefly, I'm sure you recall the story of Jesus sleeping in the middle of a storm. I'm sure when you heard the news last night, maybe you couldn't sleep that a storm was coming. But in the middle of a storm, he was asleep. And so I say to you this morning, faith is extremely important for your success, faith in God. So as you go, ensure that you go with faith in God that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That regardless of the challenges that you face, that you could be successful. I believe the experience of COVID-19 would have prepared you very well for the challenges that you are going to meet that Father Ronald spoke about this morning. And so when challenges come, the question is, what do you do? How do you respond? And so I say to you, you have been through challenges. And so you must have been convinced that in spite of challenges, you could still be successful. The second word, which is belief, if you have faith in God and you believe in yourself, that becomes extremely important for your success. So many people start the race believing that they will not win. Many people start the journey believing that they will not complete the journey. This morning, I want to encourage you to believe in yourself that you could do it, that you could be successful, that you could break all of those barriers that are going to come in your way, all of those obstacles that you are going to meet. And in spite of the challenges, you will be successful. Faith in God, belief in yourself. Don't let anyone tell you that you cannot be successful. And if they do, don't believe them. I encourage you, believe in yourself, believe that you can be successful. You are going into new environments. I beg you this morning to take all the values, all of the things that you were taught at the St. Martin de Porres School, they will become very relevant, very important to you. all of the lessons that you were taught, you would need to go back to them. Don't throw them away. And I'm not speaking here about the academic lessons only. I'm speaking about the morals and the values. And I listened to your prayer. I listened to your pledge this morning. Take them. Go with them. And I guarantee you that you will be successful in whichever school that you go to. Remembering, it is not so much about the school. It is about you, your faith in God, your belief in yourself. So I take this opportunity this morning. I want to wish you all the best. Every success. And I believe, boys as well as girls, you are going to do extremely well. I want to ask you to put your hands together again one more time for them. And as I prepare to run off, and forgive me, as soon as I'm finished, I'm going to try to catch, at least make an effort. I want to take this opportunity, as I did before, and I'm going to recognize this morning your top student, and I'm going to ask Ms. Kadu to come forward. Continue to shine as I encourage your peers to shine.
Thank you, Mrs. Pear, for your warm greetings and encouraging words that you have deposited in us today. I can say as a member of staff that we commit. I am talking for my partners in education. We commit that we will continue to excel as an institution, not only making our parents proud, but to also become a beacon in the Tri-Island State. Before we move on to our next item, we are going to look to the screen as we do our video presentation.
Congratulations, class of 2022. My name is Lisel, and I was sitting exactly where you are sitting right now, 26 years ago, in 1996. Congratulations on a job well done. You did well. Your family is proud, your parents are proud, teachers, friends, I am proud of you. But I want you to be open and have an open mind and accept these new challenges that come forth. I mean, you accepted this one and look where you are right now, right? So accept this new challenge, enjoy this moment right here. You did amazing. Enjoy this moment. Enjoy big wins. Enjoy small wins. And I wish you all the best with everything you have to do in the future. Good luck, all the best, and congrats.
Thank you. One of the highlights at all graduation ceremonies for me is the graduates' song. And we assure you are always delighted to hear the melodious voices of our children. Let us share this moment with them as they come to sing one of their songs as graduating students of the St. Martin de Porres Catholic School.
Thank you.
right. I must say that was melodious indeed. Very amazing. Just again. Again, I invite you to just turn your eyes to the screen as we make another video presentation.
Congratulations, class of 2022. My name is Liesel, and I was sitting exactly where you are. Congratulations, you did it. I am so proud of you, the graduating class of 2022. I am Sheena McMillan Johnson, and I too am a graduate of the Croatian Roman Catholic School. I am so proud. Of you, I would like to encourage you to keep striving for excellence. Congratulations, you did it. I am so proud of you, the graduating class of 2022. I am Sheena McMillan Johnson, and I too am a graduate of the Croatian Roman Catholic School. I am so proud of you. I would like to encourage you to keep striving for excellence. Don't be afraid to dream and then open your eyes and see. I'm gonna have you see some of my little students. So continue doing a great job. I know your families are proud. Here they are. Everybody say hi.
Hi.
Say congratulations. Thank you and best of luck on your journey.
Thank you. Featured addresses at any graduation exercise are the pinnacle that encourages and motivates the graduates as well as us in Foreign Head. It is with honor that we present Mr. Samuel Alexander, our featured speaker.
As a past student of the St. Martin de Porres School, Mr. Samuel Alexander has excelled both in sports and academia. This zeal to excel in both disciplines he attributes to the strong support of his parents and key teachers along the journey.
One of such was his grade 6 teacher, Miss Mayona George, who pushed him to continue performing in the classroom and on the field despite having the additional workload of being in grade six.
This level of discipline and determination was some of the values he learned right here in this institution. He graduated from the St. Martin de Porres RC School in 2008 and was given the award for being the most outstanding student athlete.
He went on to attend Grenada Boys Secondary School, where he continued to strive in both disciplines, winning multiple awards and medals for his school and country.
He graduated from GBSS in 2013 and went on to pursue mechanical engineering at the University of the West Indies, St. Augustine campus in Trinidad.
Apart from sports and academics, he is also compassionate, helpful, creative, and filled with vision. These attributes encouraged him to sort out a way to make life a bit easier for the students that would follow.
He noticed that among the many tools they used in the engineering drawing classes, There was none dedicated to assist with many drawings they had to produce. So he found a way to develop a plastic stencil that did just that. For his outstanding contribution, he was later awarded for business innovation by the University of the West Indies, St. Augustine campus, also going on to successfully graduate with a BS in mechanical engineering in 2020.
Samuel returned to Grenada shortly after, and it wasn't long before he embarked on another passion project. Only this time, it was aimed at growing the agro-processing industry in Grenada. He is the CEO of Ignite Flavors, a local agro-processing business developing high-quality product foods, both for export and local market.
Please give a warm welcome to one of our own, Mr. Samuel Alexander, as he delivers our featured address.
It's a pleasure to be here. I consider it a pleasure, and it's almost a nostalgic moment to just see y'all celebrated at this juncture of your life. But before I go on, I just want to recognize the honorary guest that we have. Although she's already departed, I just want to recognize the contribution of the parliamentary representative-elect, Mrs. Emlyn Pear. Also, the representing parish priest, Father Holder, the former Minister of Health, Mrs. David Ann Antwine, principal of this great institution, St. Martin de Porres Heresy School, Mr. Kester Lyons, other specially invited guests, celebrants, well-wishers. I wish you all a pleasant good morning. Yes, so as was mentioned before, I'm a past student of this school, and I'm familiar with your experience, and I know at this very point in time you are still tense, so I just urge you to relax. You know, just take it down a little bit. I can see the nervousness on your face, but it'll be all over soon, right? Before I continue my address, I just want to speak to the parents of the students. Just to remind you that in all of this, you are teacher number one. Remember, I didn't say first teacher, because usually the tendency is from first, you just move on to second and third, and you forget first. But you are teacher number one. And that role would never leave you. And I'm not only talking about academia, but I'm talking about principles, I'm talking about values. You are responsible for shaping these young ones. And it, by all indications, it looks like you have done a fantastic job. So give yourself a round of applause. Right. So when I was asked to take up the task of just addressing the graduating class of 2022, it caused me to do a bit of reflection on my own life, on my own experiences, and I wanted to pull some of the lessons that I have learned throughout the years and just give you some words of advice, some words of wisdom, to push you even further than me. I want the best for you, right? So coming up in my years at the then called Crochet Arcy School, one of the key things I learned was teamwork, right? And I know sometimes in your primary school experience, you feel like you're the only one that has to struggle to do your homework. You're the only one that has to try to figure out to pass your test, right? Anybody feels like that? You feel sometimes that you don't have help from anybody and you have to figure it out on your own? Nobody? So everybody has an excellent team behind them. All right, wonderful, right? But you would find there are times when you have, like you feel alone, right? And you need a solid team behind you. I urge you to get good people around you. People that would motivate you. People that would help you to be successful. I had people like that in my corner. One of the people I mentioned was my grade six teacher. At that critical time in my life where you do not know how well you would do in your exams, you are crossing over from primary school to secondary school. You do not know what to expect of CPEA. You need people in your corner, right? But one of the key things about being part of a team, it teaches you how to be helpful. And I mentioned this very important point because having a mindset of being helpful, being considerate, being observant, would be very key for you going forward, right? So when you are heading off to your new secondary school, and just by the raise of hands, let me see who, I assume that all of you all are excited about your new secondary school, but what I want to ask is, what are you excited about? When it comes to secondary school, when you think about secondary school, what are the things that get you excited to put on a new school uniform? Any answers? What? Okay, so you're... Let me try to understand. When is the better subject? Do well in your school? Your subject? Okay. Okay, so one person said they're interested in getting, like, discovering new subjects. Anybody else? I got some really interesting responses. One person said they're interested in the new subjects, right? Another person said they're interested in meeting new friends, making new relationships. Another person, they're interested in just doing well, just going there and doing the best they could, right? And all of these are very good responses. And I want to give you this word of advice. Find something that you want to excel in and go at it. Go at it hard. You might not be the best at everything, and that's okay. That's fine. But find something that you can excel in, right? And I'm not only talking about sports, although I have a little bias towards sports. And I encourage you that you should find some sort of sports to do, right? Because it helps you to be focused. It helps you to... It blocks out a lot of distractions because you have more of your time being used. You're more occupied. As I mentioned that, I'm thinking back at my years at GBSS where I was heavily involved in athletics. Now, one of the things when you commit yourself to training and you're serious about wanting to perform well for your school and for your country, you realize that you have to dedicate a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of sacrifice in training. And when the going gets tough, you want to quit, but you had to stick to it. Now, one of the things I realized is that took a lot of time away from me. Not in a bad way, but the time when I could have been going across the Carolinas, go and check some high school girl, right? The time when I could have been going in and spending the arcade or do something idle, and I'm not saying you can't have fun every now and again, but that time, if I spent majority of my time there, I would have never reached where I wanted to reach. So when you focus your time on something productive, you would see the results. As my coach used to say, train hard and win easy. So when you put the work in now, you go hard at it, you find the thing that you want to excel in, and you go hard at it, you would realize that you reap the rewards sooner rather than later, right? And life becomes a bit more easier for you, right? And next thing I wanted to encourage you is, well, one thing I wanted you to pay attention to, and this is one thing I recognize kind of late in my life. Do not let pride limit you, right? Do not let pride limit you. It kind of sounds counterintuitive, but whenever you reach to a high place, a high position, there is a temptation to get prideful. And it kind of sounds counterintuitive that when you reach high, you want to get proud and feel like you have it all. But anytime you reach to that point and you actually think you have it all, there is no more left for you. Like, there is no more in your mind that you can achieve. If you always want to achieve more, be humble. And there would always be room for God to pour into your life, for you to achieve more, for higher heights to be attained. There would always be room for you to climb once you remain humble. If there's one thing, if there's one virtue that you're allowed to stick with you, just remain humble and you have more to climb, right? Now, earlier I mentioned that having a mindset to be helpful is important. And that's one of the things you would learn from being in a team. Now, when you're growing up, I'm sure you want to have your big job. You want to have lots of money, some of y'all. I see one fella, yeah, he's signaling, yeah. And that's good. That's all fine and good, right? But here's one, you could kind of call it a secret, right? Now, I said, have a mindset to be helpful for a reason. If you have a mindset to be helpful, naturally you would be looking for opportunities to serve. And in those opportunities, there would be ways to be successful, right? So if you wanna put it in a simple formula, service equals success. The more of a boss you become, you would recognize that there are more people that you have to serve. The higher up you attain, like higher up in a position you attain, you realize there's more people you have to serve. And you would be a better leader once you have that kind of mindset, right? Being a boss, being a leader is not being on top of the food chain, telling people what to do all the time. There are elements of that, yes. But you would realize that there's more people you have to serve. So I encourage you to have a mindset of being helpful, being service-minded. It starts with the small things, being helpful around the house. Those things will train you to the larger things. As the Bible says, he who is faithful in little is also faithful in much, right? So these are my words of encouragement to you. I know it's very short. You know what? I'll entertain maybe one question. If there's anything that you would like to ask, I'll give you a listening ear and I'll give a comment based on that. Anybody want to ask anything, or y'all good for the time being? You good? All right. Well, please strive for the best. Be humble, because you have a whole lot more to achieve ahead of you. This is your first taste of success, but I'm wishing you many more moments like this, or maybe moments greater. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Alexander. And I would affectionately call him Sammy, It's always hard to call him Mr. Alexander, yeah? We are good friends. We thank you for your words of wisdom and encouragement to our graduates. Boys and girls, this morning, just want to leave you with a four little pointers that he shared. And I think it's quite profound that you go with it this morning. He said, be humble. Be humble. You know what that means? Yeah? Be humble. Not everything you get loud and rowdy and proud and cocky and all these things. Stay calm. Yes? Stay calm. Be gentle. Another thing he said, there is no growth with a prideful and a proud attitude. No growth. Thirdly, he said, be helpful. Always look out for somebody else. Be kind. You are going into an environment that you do not know. Somebody might just need your help. Don't say, not me, no. Be helpful. And to strive for the best always. Mr. Alexander, thank you again for your kind words of wisdom and encouragement to our children. God has given each one of us gifts and talents to use for the development of his kingdom and for helping others. And so today, we are blessed to have Katie Williams to minister to us in song. Let us warmly welcome Katie.
Close my eyes and I can see the world is waiting up for me that I call my own. Through the doors, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. We could live in a world that we deserve. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams, all it's gonna take. I think what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make. There's your house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I can pile each one that I make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we lost our minds. I don't care if they call this crazy. run away to the world that we desire. Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams, all it's gonna take. I think what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams, all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make. Whoever big, whoever small, let me be part of it all. Share your dreams with me. You may be right, you may be wrong, but please let you bring me along to the world you see, to the world I close my eyes to see, I close my eyes to see. Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. I think what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we gotta make.
Well, it really looked like Katie come to steal the show this morning. Thank you very much, Katie, for blessing our hearts. And during the practice sessions, some of the students came to me and they said, "Sir, when Katie sang in practice, Katie made us cry." So if there is anyone, any graduates, that is sharing a little bit of tears at the moment, I give you just quick 2 seconds to wipe those tears away and put on your smiles. Because as we move on, the most awaited moment is here. The fruits of hard work and discipline will finally be earned. To help distribute the certificates and gifts to the students, I may request Mrs. Rhonda Joseph, school counselor, to join us on the stage.
Tyrona Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, Naomi Moraine.
Diamond Charles.
Our song star, Katie Williams.
Ariana Lalsi.
Put your hands together for Angel Japal.
Anila Isaac.
Angenic Panchu.
Gabriella McQuilkin.
Jediah Lessie.
Tiana James.
Chalissa Sparks.
Fiona Jackson.
Nevea St. Hilaire.
Kenya Raymond.
Kimia Mitchell.
Jorel Phillips.
Jade Alexander.
Jordan Mitchell.
Nazelle Alexis.
Jadonna Alexander.
Haley Felix.
Ruth Macmillan.
Sarah Augustine.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Joseph, for presenting the certificates and gifts. We now call Mr. Peter Ridges to join us on the stage. Latasha Cadu. Jaden Frank.
Kelron Augustus.
Kaden Bowen. Kaden.
Amaru Alexander.
Dante Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andel Maureen.
Joachim Jeremiah.
Christian Lessie.
Deshaun Grant.
Ashkel Hamilton.
Jaden Brathwaite.
Ramon George.
Jadiah Batiste.
LeSean Mitchell.
Jaron Phillip.
Gianna Gilbert.
Joel Samuel.
Ariella McQuilkin.
Milano Phillip.
Tahira Brafwit.
And finally, Brianna Francis.
Ladies and gentlemen, join us in congratulating the graduates of the class of 2022.
Success is no accident. It is hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrifice, and most of all, love of what you are doing. Today we honor these students for their commitment and dedication to their studies. To do so, we invite teachers Nikaya and Kami to present to us the special awardees of the graduating class of 2022.
Mrs. Emmeline Payne, absence, parliamentary representative elect. Father Ronald Holder, representing the parish priest. Mrs. Anne David Antwine, former Minister of Health. Mr. Peter Regis, district education officer. Mrs. Maria Viveg, executive secretary of the Catholic Education Board of Management. Mrs. Rhonda Joseph, the school's counselor. Mr. Ernest Richardson, Mrs. Christine Smith, and Mr. Roland Hood, school attendant officers, Mrs. Rolanda McQueen, former senator, Mr. Samuel Alexander, guest speaker, Mrs. Rikisha St. Louis, president of the school's PTA, our retired and past teachers, our special invited guest, principal, teachers, parents, well wishers. Graduates, good afternoon. Today, my colleague and I stand before you to present the recipients of special awards. To do so, we invite Mr. Kitaka Mawuto to assist with the first half of the presentation.
Enter to learn, go forth to serve. We at this noble institution thrive on this motto, and we implore our students that as they enter the walls, They carry out this legacy by serving diligently, by always striving for excellence. Today, we present the Academic Awards to the following students. These students showcased a high level of academic intelligence throughout their tenure at this institution. Anelia Isaac. Jediah Lessie. Jadonna Alexander. Jade Alexander. Latasha Kadum. Irona Mark. Christian Lessie. These awards are sponsored by Mr. Samuel Alexander, Mr. Timothy Mitchell, Mr. Aidan McMillan, Mrs. Salisha Thomas-Silly, Mr. Kitaka Mohoto, Mr. Steve Brockwith, Mr. Trevor Mitchell, and Ms. Simone Pear.
The American mathematician William Paul Thurston once said, "Mathematics is not about numbers, equation, computation, or algorithms. It is about understanding." The Mathematics Awards this year go to Dante Jones and Ramon George. These awards are sponsored by Mr. Damian Moraine and Mrs. Latoya Kedu.
Practice makes improvement. And Ander Moraine and Kenaya Raymond have truly represented this philosophy. We therefore proudly present them with the Trevor Mitchell and Nissel Pay Award. Andel Moraine and Kenaya Raymond.
Our apologies, we left out one awardee for the Academic Awards, Jayana Gilbert. Discipline should be a way of life. And Nazel Alexis, Brianna Francis, and Jaden Braffitt have exemplified this trait. Today, we award them for this. Nazel Alexis, Brianna Francis, and Jaden Braffitt. These awards were sponsored by Mrs. Leslyn Sylvester, Mr. Kitaka Maoto, and Teacher Cinti.
In the words of Mr. Brian Green, and I quote, "Science is a process that takes us from confusion to understanding," end of quote. The Science Award for 2022 goes to Nazelle Alexis and Kaden Bowen. This award are sponsored by Ms. Nazinga Mowoto and Mr. Louis Fortune.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mowoto. We now invite Mrs. Annabelle Pei to assist with the second half of the presentation of awards.
At this institution, we promote the all-round development of our students. Over the years, sports have been an integral part of our curriculum. Today, we present Christian Lessie and Jayana Gilbert with this award. This award is sponsored by Mr. Kitaka Mowoto.
The Brownies Award. These awardees have been active members of the Brownie Club throughout their primary school life and have contributed greatly to its success. We present the Brownies Awards to the following persons: Jade Alexander, Fiona Jackson, Angenic Panchu, Chelissa Sparks, Tiana James, and thank you for your dedication.
The 4-H Club Award. For the 4-H Award, join the 4-H Club from the infant and would have grown and developed into committed members. It's the Jediah Lessie. Ramon George. Deshaun Grant. Amuru Alexander. Jediah Batiste. And Christian Lessie. Most outstanding, and this award is from Brian Azad. Thank you.
positive work ethic.
And stood for excellence. She worked hard to ensure all students, especially the underprivileged, were not left behind. Her passion for reading and education on a whole were unprecedented. It is very...
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord,
it's so good to us. We give you all the praise. We gotta say thank you, and Lord, it's your glory, stand up for you. We sit by your side, yeah. We gotta say thank you.
For Westerhall Secondary, your registration is on the 5th of July. In the event, it's the same day as graduation. Well, that doesn't actually fall with us. So you are to walk with a graduation fee, a registration fee of $300. Students are to walk with one passport size picture and birth certificate. Again, that is for Westerhall. A starting time was not given for Westerhall. All right, so that's it on the announcements. And as the saying goes, all good things must come to an end. As we pull the curtains down, I would like to encourage the graduates to forever remember the pledge of this gracious institution. As it says, go forward in faith and be kind to one another, ensuring that every day you grow stronger and stronger, wiser and wiser, better and better. At this time, we request everyone to stand as the graduates proceed jubilantly as we come to a close of today's celebration. Thank you, everyone, for coming, and enjoy the rest of your afternoon.